What's going on, everybody? My name is Japes, and welcome to a Friday episode of My Path to Power. As you can see, just about everybody has sold there on the screen. We started at about 98,000 coins. Now we're up to 125,000 coins, so some nice profit in there. 27,000 coins for just a little bit of trading. Though I do quite a foolish thing, as you're about to see on the screen right now. I go out and buy a premium jumbo pack. It was happy hour yesterday, and I got slapped in the face for doing it. Just a brutally terrible pack. Highest player 78 Babel. That is just brutal. No such luck there. I should have cut my losses with Tevez and never ever bought a pack again. But at least I know to stop there. And to be fair, that kind of motivated me to go out and do some more trading, which you guys will see in the upcoming, I don't know, I think it might happen some in this episode, but definitely more in the upcoming episodes. But we're still rolling with that exact same Brazilian side. And here's Marcelo has sold. And you can see I bought two players. I bought the 86 Shinji Kagawa set as a striker for 30,000 coins. Think I'll be able to sell him for somewhere around 40, which would be excellent. So 10K profit on one card. Take that 10 times out of 10. Lucas Barrios here, hoping to make a cool 5K on him. And as you can see, we had a few more players on our watch list right there. It wasn't a power hour. I was just watching some TV. Figured I'd try to trade some cards and work it along that way. I'm doing some adjustments to my team right there. Didn't feel like going out and buying a fitness card just quite yet, as a Brazilian team is quite easy to swap around players for. There are quality options at the CAM positions, and so it's easy to do that. But getting things kick-started here. Pato breaking free, some brilliant build-up play, little back heel, another little back heel. Talk dirty with that kind of finish. It's Neymar there in the 20th, and that's what we're looking for to get things started. I'd missed some chances before that, and so I wanted to make sure to be able to score that one. Another quick and easy there with Macquizel. This tournament has been my nemesis far and above previous to any tournament that I've played. If you remember last time, we got kicked off the EA servers there in like the semifinal or final round, so we had to make sure that this time we were going to win. And once I scored that goal in the 20th, the floodgates had opened. Neymar again there in the 33rd. Nice little long shot on the man. And that was about all this guy could handle. He ends up quitting out. Connection has been lost. It's not the servers that time. So it is a happy day. And that was there in the 36th minute. But we're going square away. Maybe doing a little shuffle in here. Got some contract issues. But if you remember, we bought that premium jumbo pack. Might have bought a couple bronze packs here or there as well. So we do have contracts. The only player out of position right now is Anderson. He said as a CM, we would love to get him as a CDM. But for right now, it's no big deal. He's just filling in for Kaká a game here or a game there. But coming up against C360 and his Brazilian or Russian 41212, I believe is what it was. He scores there in the 12th minute. Kind of tackled it, went right back to him. Get across here in the 29th, and Neymar actually wins the header. I'm trying to hunt down and figure out who exactly told me that they just didn't like Neymar on Ultimate Team. I think it might have been Josh Flipp, but that man is crazy. Neymar is just an absolute tank for me. He's so good. I think I'm going to go out, and I'm going to try to spend some coins and get the 87 Neymar eventually. You guys will have to leave in the comments if you used him before. If you think he is better than his regular version, and if so, how drastically can you tell? Another cross here, another goal, and that's just a really easy cross because Potter was wide open. I just found out the other day that my crossing had been on manual for the majority of FIFA. I've turned it on semi, and things have just gotten so much easier. Well, I win a penalty here in the 69th, and you know what that means, straight up, straight down the middle. That's some dirty talk. We're taking over this match. So we're 3-2 here, and some nice work again here. The 4-2-3-1 with this Brazil side is just working for me. It's just the right formation, right team. I haven't always liked the 4-2-3-1 formation. I've been playing around with it a little bit more on my main account with some other teams, but with the Brazilian side, it just absolutely works wonders. You get to use all the players that you want to use, minus maybe Hulk and Michel Bastos. But those are really the only two wingers that I would put in as like top buys for a Brazilian side. We go out and we buy a squad fitness card here. Got to make sure that going into the final, I think we're into the semi right now, but going into the semi, at least we have our players at all their top fitness so that the semi and final can be played in the best possible conditions to get that W, get that 6,000 coins. So essentially, if you look at it in terms of tournament costs, we're going to be, you know, it'll have paid, I think I paid 1500, so really we'll only be winning about 4500 coins for the final, but that's still pretty good. Left trigger, right trigger movements from Neymar here. He just didn't know what to do. And that's it's such a strong move, especially done with the right players. Just absolutely incredible. You'll just blow by players, and that's a goal there in the second minute straight away from the kickoff. And I was feeling real confident at this point, especially when it's 10 minutes later and we managed to just swoop by him here, and he's just going to give Robinho a finesse shot. And an ultimate team, that's going in just about 10 times out of 10. So we take an early 2-goal lead. And at this point, I was thinking it was time to have some fun. So Thiago Silva bursting forward, his defense bit debatable there. Unlucky shot gets blocked, but we end up finding Lucas, a little elastico chop, or what is it? Yeah, I think it's an elastico chop is what it's called, and 30th minute goal. Can you hear me, boys? I love just a one little proper skill move just to get inside, but tackling there, it goes right back to Robinho. Thought I was a bit unlucky with the drop, but I guess it would have been a foul anyway, deemed by the wonderful referee AI, which is going to be improved for FIFA 13. He scores another header there with Wellington, but the referees are going to be drastically improved in FIFA 13, so I hear. They've been working heavily on that, which is excellent news. At this point though, I dropped 2 goals, and I thought he might be coming back. The comeback might be on, but Alexander Pato seals it for me in the 85th minute there, and gets that 2-goal lead back. But we're working free again here, and Pato slips a wonderful little ball. He just kicks it square into Neymar, and Neymar, little step over work inside, clinically into the bottom corner. That's an easy goal. And I believe that's how that one's going to end, 5-2. But we will be doing a stream at some point this weekend. I got to say that. I'm kind of anxious to get back at streaming. I'm actually thinking I'm going to take the afternoon off today. So you guys might be seeing me on the stream. If you guys want to see that later, tweet me, let me know. But we come up against this guy, 4-3-1-2 team, in a pretty beastly side at that. Hopefully trying to win this final, and some brilliant work here from Pato. Just blows by his defender, and at this point he's flustered. He wants to tackle me. Nice little roulette and clinically into the bottom corner with his left foot in the 16th minute. At this point, I'm thinking the final is mine. Let's get this show on the road. Give me them coins. Give me them trophy. Gotta get that silverware. And we are going to be well on our way. But he was actually a pretty good player. He adapted very well to my style of play. And that's Pato right there. Again, 19th minute, scoring 2 goals. At this point, I was like, it's over. Not blowing a 2-goal lead. No way, no how, not going to happen. Really poor defending for me right there. And he finds just an absolutely incredible pass to Pato. I don't know what my defense was doing, sleeping right there, but Pato finds it, does a little and one action, puts it off the post, and then puts it in. And that's apparently a penalty. I thought I'd done okay, but apparently he just kicked my leg, and that was a penalty. Really poor penalty stopping for me right here. Though going down the middle are always tough to read, using the way I like to try to block penalties, which is looking at players' feet. It doesn't work. It works. The same principles still apply. But we switch our formation here in to the 4-2-2-2 formation just because the middle started to feel a bit congested. That happens when you play people with a 4-3-1-2 sometimes. Got to try to exploit the wings. But my penalty kick stopping thing is, if their foot's clear, it depends. If it's power, I can generally stop them. And more often than not, it works for me, which helps me win most games that do go to penalties. But right here, 105th minute, just cut across it back, take the goal. It was a tough match, well fought from him. But that's going to put us ahead for the 3-2 lead, and that is how the tournament will end. We will take our coins. Thank you very much. And we finally have another trophy to go into the pile. We got some trading hopefully coming on after this. Next episode will be out tomorrow. I think it's going to actually be a path to power as well. Anyways, guys, I appreciate your support on this. If you did enjoy the episode, please feel free to give a thumbs up. Other than that, my name is Japes, and I will catch you all next time.